To politics back home now, and today is the first day of the new financial year. Joining us live is the Shadow Finance Minister, Jane Hume. Jane, good to see you. Thanks for your time. Happy financial year, new financial year to you. So we've got tax cuts, pay rises, energy bill relief, extra super from today, lots of goodies. How are you feeling about it all?
Well, it's extraordinary, isn't it, that Anthony Albanese and Labor Party are now promising that things will be easier in this new financial year, but it sounds like we're back to the future here. This is exactly what they were promising over 2 years ago, and yet Australians are worse off under Labor. We've seen real wages collapse by around 9%, living standards collapse by 8%. People's standard of living has gone down. And because of that, if you are feeling poorer, there's a good reason, you actually are poorer. Housing's gone up by over 11%. Rents have gone up by around 14.2%. Food's gone up by around 11%. Health, education have gone up by around 8% or so. This is an extraordinary period of time, and Australians are doing it really tough. Anthony Albanese said 2 years ago that he thought he had all the solutions. You'll recall before the last election, he was snapping pictures on his phones of petrol bowsers, petrol pumps and the price of petrol, saying that he had solutions for that. I don't think that Australians are convinced that Anthony Albanese has the solutions to really bring inflation back under control. And I'm not entirely sure that the RBA does.
Okay, so back to these assistance measures that start from today. Do you think they will help folks at home, or do you think those measures will just get swallowed up by increased costs?
Well, certainly if inflation continues to rise, those tax cuts will be eaten up very quickly indeed, and people will not feel their real disposable income increase, which is what they're crying out for, because it's gone backwards so far under the last 2 years of this government. It's gone back by around 8%. So that's why you're feeling poorer, and you will continue to do so unless the government can tame inflation. And it can only do that using its fiscal levers, not simply relying on the Reserve Bank to keep jacking up interest rates.
Do you think these measures that start today will be inflationary, that will add to the problem rather than fix it?
Well, certainly these are questions that we asked of the Treasury Secretary.
What do you think,
Secretary, during estimates? Well, this is why we asked the Treasury Secretary. It was the government and the Treasury that asserted that there were no inflationary measures in this budget. That it remains to be seen. Certainly the RBA seemed to be unimpressed, and as they see inflation rise, that unexpected rise in monthly inflation that we saw last week, not just the 4% headline inflation, but the 4.4% underlying inflation, that had jumped up such a long way. That's what the RBA is going to concentrate on when it next makes its decision.
Okay. Just a different topic now, Jane. The Prime Minister has indefinitely suspended Senator Fatima Payman from Labor caucus meetings. Have you got a view on that this morning?
Well, it certainly took long enough. I mean, I think this is a sign of a weak Prime Minister, the fact that Senator Payman defied him, directly defied him, not once, not twice, but three times. First with a press conference where she said that hateful phrase that I'm not going to repeat here, but something that the Prime Minister himself had said is anti-Semitic and incites violence. Then she crossed the floor, and then after being hit with the wet lettuce of a suspension from one caucus meeting, which is, you know, quite frankly, more a reward than a punishment, only after she then went on Insiders and made a goose of the Deputy Prime Minister, did the Prime Minister finally act to suspend her. You can understand why his caucus are so furious. I can remember Bill Shorten saying when he was Prime Minister that if you cross the floor, that equals expulsion in the Labor Party. Well, obviously, the rules are different under Anthony Albanese, but this is the first time since 1986 that anybody has crossed the floor. And when that happened, Bob Hawke immediately suspended.
Okay, so was the PM right to do it, in your view? Staring across the aisle?
Well, I think that's a decision for the Prime Minister. It's his party's rules. It's not my party's rules. But quite frankly, the fact that he took so long to act is a demonstration of the respect in which he is held, clearly, by Senator Payman, and a sign of the weak leadership that he's shown, particularly on this issue of Gaza, Israel and Hamas in Gaza, since October the 7th.
Jane Hume, we'll have to leave it there. Appreciate your time, though. We'll talk to you soon.